Hey guys, and we got some NASCAR news, some silly season news about David Ragan will retire from full-time Cup Series racing after this year in 2019. He currently drives the number 38 Ford Mustang for Front Row Motorsports, which is a really small, underfunded team, and he's raced for that team a lot. And in his NASCAR career, he has one ARCA Menard Series win, one Gainer Outdoors Truck Series win, two NASCAR Xfinity Series wins, and two NASCAR Cup Series wins. And the first of them coming with Roush Fenway Racing in 2011 at the Coke Zero 400 at Daytona. He got his first career Cup Series win in that UPS 6 car. And it was a humongous underdog win, and it was kind of an upset, if you would say. And David Ragan got his first career Cup Series win. And it didn't end then. He got his second career Cup Series win in 2013 at Talladega, another restrictor plate track, so he's pretty good at those. And and this time it was for Front Row Motorsports in the 34 car, the same team he races for now, except now he's in the 38. And his teammate back then, David Gilliland, who was in the 38, pushed him to the win, and 1-2 finish for Front Row Motorsports. And it was a huge win for David Gilliland as well, even though he didn't cross the finish line first, and a huge win for Bob Jenkins, who owns Front Row Motorsports, and they got that 1-2 finish with David Ragan winning the race, and there he is doing his burnout. And in 2015, Kyle Busch got injured in the NASCAR Xfinity Series race the day before the Cup Series race happened, and since he was injured, they put Matt Crafton in the Daytona car, but then for most of the other races, David Ragan was the fill-in, so he was driving the number 18 Joe Gibbs Racing car. He did not win a race, but he was actually pretty solid. He wasn't bad. I mean, obviously not as good as Kyle Busch because, I mean, he won the championship that year. But so David Ragan kind of split three rides that year. So he was Joe Gibbs sometimes in the 18 car, replacing injured Kyle Busch. And he also raced for Michael Waltrip Racing in the 55 car. That was their final year. He kind of split that ride with Brett Moffitt. And then he was in the 34 as well, which he raced for Daytona. He already had that car. That's why they put Crafton in the 18 after Kyle got injured. And David Ragan, with Front Row Motorsports, Michael Waltrip Racing, and Joe Gibbs Racing in the 2015 season, it was pretty chaotic. And this Front Row Motorsports team is the same team he won with in 2013 Talladega. So David Ragan retiring from full-time Cup Series racing. He's still going to do some Cup Series races next year. Will it be for Front Row Motorsports? We're not sure. We don't know who's going to replace David Ragan in that 38 car full-time. Will there be a full-time driver in that car? Or maybe Ragan and somebody else will split that car next year. You know, you don't know. But Ragan will be part-time next year, just don't know what team, but he will not be full-time for Front Row Motorsports next year, and he announced that early this morning. And some more NASCAR news. So, at Road America, which is not next week, but the week after, in the NASCAR Xfinity Series, they only go there, it's a road course, Matt Dibenedetto, which we know is a pretty good road course racer, we learned that this year in the Cup Series, and he is going to be racing in the number 18 Joe Gibbs Racing Toyota Supra in the NASCAR Xfinity Series at Road America in the IK9 car, which now Jeffrey Earnhardt's not in, and they had to fill in with Jack Hawksworth in Mid-Ohio. And Jack Hawksworth did pretty well, and Dibenedetto is going to get a Joe Gibbs car in the NASCAR Xfinity Series, so that's pretty crazy. So that's a really good thing for him, really good equipment. He has a really good shot to win. He's really good at road courses in good equipment, Joe Gibbs Racing Xfinity Series equipment. But there is some bad news for Matt Dibenedetto. On Twitter, Adam Stern, who is a NASCAR insider, reported that it is kind of unlikely for Matt Dibenedetto to return to the number 95 car for Levine Family Racing next year in 2020. And that's just because Toyota has invested so much in Christopher Bell, so much in Eric Jones, and they're not going to lose those drivers. Okay. And it's not going to come up to who they want, really. It's going to come up with to funding and money. And that's just how racing is these days. And so, I mean, it's not official, but it looks like Matty D might not be in that 95 car next year. And that's really unfortunate. So it might be Christopher Bell in that car if they don't open up a second Levine car for him, or a second Levine car for Jones, because Bell might go to the 20 where Jones is now for Joe Gibbs Racing, and then Jones goes to Levine Family Racing in the 95. So unfortunate for Matty D, but that's the way it's got to be. Hopefully, if he gets the boot from Levine, he can find an even better team to race for, like maybe Stuart Haas. But yeah, so David Ragan retiring from full-time Cup Series racing. He said he's doing this because he wants to spend more time with his family. He wants to see them grow up because they're growing up fast. He says he wants to be a better father. He wants to be a better husband. And that's why he's doing it. He's not stepping away from racing, still part-time next year, but not any full-time. So he's going to be a better husband, better father, see his kids grow up even more, and spend time with his family and wife and children. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I really, really appreciate it. And I'll see you next time. Bye.